Shut up and sit down.
Hi, hello. I'm the Cyber Guru. Thank you for watching. So once again, this is going to be a vlog about a variety of random things. Not the least of which, start off with, I am not in my normal location. I am out on travel again. I have been traveling a lot. So much so that I have not been able to keep a consistent project schedule nor a consistent project video. So I queued up a bunch of videos, which have all now aired, and I appreciate y'all for watching, so thumbs up if you like them. But so right now I am stuck in this kind of lull where I'm out traveling. I can't do anything from a maker perspective, so I'm just going to vlog about the fact that I've been traveling my ass off. It's okay. I'm not going to talk about my work. It's okay. What I do want to talk about are some things that I've been doing that I'm going to queue up for future videos, and I hope you enjoy this, and I hope you watch the video. So let's get to it. So recently I've been watching a lot of videos about the new MacBook Air, MacBook Pro that came out. I'm toying with buying a new one. This computer turns out is ridiculously old. I had no idea how old it was until I looked into it. I've been using it without really thinking about it, and it turns out that I bought it in 2012. 5 years ago. Five, six. Nothing like that. 2012. Oh my goodness. So it's getting a little long in the tooth. I've noticed this recently. I've been doing a lot of video editing, and it just takes a long time to do things. But more importantly, the CAD work that I'm doing in Fusion 360 is taking forever. I don't know what Autodesk has done with their SVG import and the way that they process vectors, but it sucks. It absolutely sucks. I'm sorry, Autodesk, you need to get your collective crap together. I've spent the last, I flew out on Tuesday, so Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and half of Saturday, futzing with a file that literally would crash Fusion every single time I would try to do something with it. Importing the SVG, doing an extrude, opening CAD, adding a setup in CAD, adding a toolpath in CAD, one toolpath, adding a second toolpath, crashes every single time. Oh my God, AutoCAD, for the love of God, it's not that complex. I switched over to Easel. Yes, that's right. Inventables makes this website. It's called Easel. It's super easy to use. I switched over to Easel. I did everything I needed to do in Easel in like 15 minutes. I was super skeptical. I'm not a big fan of Easel. I don't like web-based CAD tools. I don't. I tried Onshape. Not a fan. I tried the new Autodesk web, not a fan. I like clients, I don't know why, it's just me, I'm like an 80s guy, I don't know, it doesn't really matter. I tried the Easel, I got what I needed out of it, I did the thing that I was making. I've been commissioned by my significant other to make some stuff for some people, which I will make a video about later. Yes, I laugh because she commissions me all the time, and then I gotta do stuff, and it's okay because she's cute, and it doesn't really matter. So Easel, super easy to use. If you're not doing like heavy CAD work, you can get it to do what you want it to do. I've not used it in the past because I do lots of different cuts with different bits, and I do all sorts of crazy things, and Easel only supports basically a roughing and a finishing pass, and that's okay. But in this case, it worked out well for me. I I'm gonna make a whole video about it, about the Easel and the inlay I did with Easel. And then I'm going to do another video about I've recently started using resins, color cast resins. You make the two epoxy resins, and you put a little color in it, and you pour it into the pockets, and then you can sand it smooth, and it looks freaking amazing. It's like 1,000 times easier than the inlays that I've been doing. I think the inlays are more impactful when you got that wood and it's nice and tight and it's you got the color contrasting of the wood. It's more impressive to some people, I want to say. But the resins, and again, I'll do a whole video about this. The projects look amazing. So back to the MacBook Pro. So you know, there's been this kind of what have they been calling it? The throttle gate, some ridiculous internet flashy throttle gate thing about the MacBook Pros. Completely immaterial. That's really not what I'm here to talk about. This guy needs to be upgraded. It really does. The camera's not so bad. I really want to upgrade my camera, but I got to be honest with you, I cannot drop $1,000 on a camera for this. Maybe. If I get more into this, I don't know, but this is literally a side job. So I've been doing a lot of work in the garage recently, and the GoPro knockoff that I have from China is not really working very well, and I can't really bring the web camera in, so I might have to get some sort of point-and-shoot camera. There's one from Canon that doesn't look too bad, and I have an old one from Sony from back in the day. It doesn't do 1080p, but we'll have to figure that out. So hey, if you're watching this and you made it this far, I appreciate it. But if you have any suggestions on cameras that are relatively inexpensive, I'd appreciate it. Kate and Evelyn, Evan and Katelyn. God, I probably could have screwed up tomorrow. Katelyn and Evan have a link in the stuff that they use, and they have a relatively inexpensive camera. I might investigate that. I really like their videos. I like the way they do their post-production, so we'll have to figure that out. And the last thing I just want to mention, so I've been watching a lot of, again, YouTube videos about the iMac and the Mac and the MacBook Pro and whatnot, but I stumbled across this channel, iJustine, which is fascinating to me. She's a she, and let's just talk about tech and she's, right? So there's not a lot of she's in tech. I know it sounds misogynistic if you want to look at it that way, but it is what it is. And I'm not going to say what I was going to say. I was going to say be something kind of rude. But the point is she does really great work, and so far I've stumbled across a couple women who have been doing really great videos about tech work, and I think that's amazing, and I think there should be more women in tech. I felt this for a long, long time, and it's just the way that it is. There needs to be much more diversity, not in terms of race and sex, but just more diversity. I work in a male-dominated field. I was just at a conference this past week, and literally on my two hands, there were 350 people at the conference. I could count the women on these two hands. That's really sad. It really is. So there needs to be more women in tech, and so iJustine, go for it. Rock on, sister. That's the way to go. And the last thing I just want to mention, I know I said the last thing was the last thing, but this really not the last thing because I want to mention. If you are not following, was it Simeone Gertz? Something like this. It's a Swedish name, so I'm sure I mispronounced it. So she had brain surgery recently. She had, I think she called it Bob. Bob was her brain tumor, and she wanted Bob out of her brain. But the long and short of it is, I actually created a vlog a couple, I don't know, about a month and a half ago, which I never posted, about this. It was more about me and my emotional attachment to people that are now dead. Doesn't really matter. But the point is she weathered the brain tumor well, and I wish her all the best. I think she's amazing. Again, another woman in a very male-dominated field. She's doing well for herself. So props to her. Props to iJustine. Props to everyone else that I've watched recently. So I think that's important. So, hey, this is just a random sort of stream of consciousness sort of video. I will post it here in the next couple days or two. I've got a number of projects in the queue that I am trying to make. I got some comments back that people want to see more 3D printing and electronics. I got one of those in the pipeline. I've been doing a lot of woodworking recently, like raw woodworking, not CNC work. So I posted a couple of those. The views are kind of meh, but you know, they are what they are. I enjoy it, so I'm gonna post about it. So you know, if you don't like it, then don't view it. It's fine. And then I do have some upcoming CNC videos. I want to show you the resin video. It's really awesome. The output is just amazing. You got to see it. And then, you know, the typical sort of inlay one that I did, but I used easel instead. So I'll probably do kind of like an easel 101 a little bit about this and show you how to do an inlay on easel. I don't know that I've seen a video on this. I'm sure that there is. I'm sure the Inventable people have posted one. But I might get audacious and like reach out to them as like, hey, I'm going to do this video. Do you want to like, you know, throw a brother a bone or something like this? I don't know. We'll see. But I'm, again, not really interested in monetizing this channel necessarily. I've gotten a fair number of subscribers in the last couple weeks, months, over 500. So that's awesome. Thanks everyone for that. Only 500 more to go till I can choose to monetize the channel if I want to. Whatever. Damn YouTube. You know, I won't rant about that right now. It is what it is. But I feel like partnering, I want to get more into partnering, not with corporations necessarily to make money or like endorsements, but I'm going to partner with people and with other folks to just make more interesting content for you. So I am looking for your suggestions. If you have any suggestions, please leave them down below. I'm very interested in that. Anything you want to know, anything you want to hear, maybe we'll do some sort of Q&A or something. I don't know. I'm just kind of spitballing ideas here. So appreciate you watching. If you liked the video, if you made it this far, please give it a thumbs up. As always, if you didn't like it, nope. That's right. Thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe. Subscribing is very important these days. Thumbing up apparently is very good. And let's get on after it. So thanks everyone for watching. We'll see you soon.